With turbocharged engines, essentially, to start with, the limit on how much power we can make is really going to come down to how well the head gasket seals. You can kind of think of this a little bit like a fuse, and at some point the cylinder pressure becomes so great that it'll escape out past the head gasket, then into the coolant system, and then it's going to end up blowing coolant out of our radiator into the overflow. Never a good result. However, of course, there are aftermarket solutions that will improve the head gasket sealing. We're here with Christian from Nitto Performance Engineering to talk about the development of an aftermarket head gasket. Now, specifically here, Christian, I want to talk about your development for the Toyota G16E engine. It's become very popular. It's in the GR Yaris and the GR Corolla, and people are getting now insane power levels out of this little three-cylinder 1.6-litre engine. For a start, what is the limiting factor on the factory gasket that Toyota provide on that engine?
So the limiting factor that we found with the gasket provided by Toyota, we'll be honest, is still a fairly competent head gasket, mainly based around materials and the lack of the stainless steel O-ring that we include in all of our gaskets where applicable. That is where the main weaknesses lie.
In terms of upgrading the clamping force, one of the first places a lot of people go is to fit something like an aftermarket head stud kit that provides more physical clamping force to the head. Is that a viable solution, and how far will that get you on a factory gasket?
It is a viable solution to a degree. How far it will get you on a factory gasket, it's still largely an unknown quantity. But however, we have come up with our own solution that can actually withstand far greater clamping force.
Okay, now you've talked about this stainless O-ring. So can you talk to us a little bit more about what that actually means and how it improves the head gasket sealing?
Yep. So basically, that stainless steel O-ring is a feature that we've incorporated into all of our gaskets. And what it does is it enables the head gasket to actually seal off the combustion chamber far more efficiently and more tightly.
Now, there's a bit of a balancing act here, because the head gasket has, as I see it, at least three functions. Obviously, we want to contain that cylinder pressure. That's really important. But two other factors that people often forget about is it's also there to seal the oil between the block and the head, and also the returns, and also the water jacket as well. How complex is it to basically achieve those three aims with the same product?
Look, it is definitely complex, but over the years, we've managed to refine our craft and develop our head gasket so that we've overcome a lot of the difficulties in the past. With our bead sealing technology combined with our O-ring, or the stainless steel O-ring for the bore, we've largely managed to overcome those issues now. And you have people in RB26 configuration running well over 1500, nearly touching 1600 horsepower with our RB26 1.2 head gasket. So fairly safe to say that we've managed to overcome any of the pre-existing issues.
Now, a lot of the technologies for sort of serious high boost drag racing engines has always been to do away essentially with a conventional gasket and use maybe a stainless ring that actually cuts into the cylinder head. There's some downsides with that in terms of damage to the head though, correct?
Yeah, that's definitely correct.
And this technology you're using with the O-ring, it doesn't do any damage to the block or the head?
No damage to the block or head whatsoever. In actual fact, we do have people that want to reuse the gasket after having used it. We don't recommend to. We always recommend to use a brand new gasket. But the good thing about our stainless steel O-rings is you don't even need to cut a receiver groove into the block or the head. Makes everything far more user-friendly.
Now, you just brought up a point that I actually wanted to dig into. So let's come back to that. Reusability of multi-layer steel head gaskets. This is an area where I've never been able to get a clear answer from any gasket manufacturer. A lot of people do reuse them and seemingly have good results. What are the potential downsides with reusing one? You've obviously just mentioned it isn't recommended.
Look, it isn't recommended largely down to the fact that it's already been torqued down properly. If it's been used for an extended period of time, it's always a matter of just wanting to go for a new head gasket. It's a fairly cheap and affordable safety net to use. So we would always recommend it for that reason.
I always looked at it from the perspective of the cost of the head gasket versus the labor for removing and reinstalling the cylinder head. To me, it just didn't make sense to sort of roll the dice with reusing a gasket. Now, I want to come back to the technology that you're using at Nitto to actually develop these gaskets, because it's quite novel. You've got a sort of a pressure sensitive film or paper, I guess. Can you talk to us about what that is and how it works?
Yeah, so what we use is a Fuji pre-scale pressure film. And what we do with this, We cut the film to suit the stud pattern of the gasket that we're testing. We then put this film on the base, on the deck of the block, put the gasket on top, put the head on top, torque down the head properly, three-step process, everything done properly, leave the head gasket to settle for only a little bit, maybe 5 minutes or so. We untension the head and then lift the head off and check the results.
So then it's left with an imprint essentially on that film. Yes. So from how dark the imprint is, as I understand it, this will give you an indication of the clamping pressure?
Precisely. So what happens is in our particular film, it's a red ink or dye that comes out. The darker that red, the higher the pressure.
Okay, and then with an understanding of using that film over and over again, you can sort of get an indication of how good your clamping is versus a factory gasket?
Yeah, absolutely. And we always do compare our head gaskets to the factory gasket. Unfortunately, we didn't bring the results from the factory gasket here today. Every single head gasket that we produce has always been back-to-back with a factory head gasket to make sure and validate the fact that we have improved upon the previous head gasket.
This sort of, I think, would also show up one of the concerns I've always had with some of the aftermarket head studs is that the torque that you can use is so dramatically greater than what the factory head bolts are spec'd to that I often have concerns about actually essentially bowing the head between the studs and essentially then making the clamping worse. So this would show up if that was the situation?
Absolutely, it would, yep.
Now, as I understand it, this G16E gasket is in the final stages of development and you're about to do some on-engine testing. How far away from public release is it?
Hard to say exactly how far away from public release is. As we've said, we've completed the pressure film testing and that's passed with flying colours to our standards. All that's left to do is to give it to a workshop that can actually give it a go in a car. Maybe best case scenario, we're talking 3 to 4 months away, plus production. So you always have to enable some extra or allow for extra time for production.
Probably also worth mentioning, we are now recording this end of August 2024. Yeah. So depending when people are watching this, maybe it's already available. If people are interested in purchasing, how are they best to do so?
Best way to purchase the head gasket or any product of ours for that matter, you can log on to our website, www.nitto.com.au. Go to our dealers page where we have a comprehensive dealer network listed there and you can get in contact with a dealer of ours to get the product.
Perfect. Thanks so much for your time, Christian.
Thank you very much, Andre.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.